the city of brotherly love. MLB The Show has baseball from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Today, it's game two of a three-game weekend set between the Colorado Rockies and the Philadelphia Phillies. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian welcoming you into another edition of Baseball on the Show. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, let's focus first on the two starters that get the ball here this afternoon.
Yeah, and you've got a couple of guys here that aren't afraid to challenge you at the plate. They're not afraid to let you put the ball in play and let their fielders make the plays behind them. That should make for a pretty good matchup.
More from the guys as this one goes along. But first, let's bring in a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Colorado Rockies. As their order here this afternoon will look like this. They'll square off versus statistically one of the best starting pitchers in postseason history, the former Cy Young Award winner left-hander Cliff Lee. Now we'll look at the way the Phillies will line up behind him. Charlie Blackmon will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway. And the first pitch of the afternoon is taken for ball one as we get underway in Philadelphia. Eric, these Phillies as they begin play here today, fair to say they're not playing their best baseball right now. Losers of five of their last six.
When you're looking at trying to get out of a funk like this, it always helps when you can hand the ball over to a veteran starter that's been through this before. And luckily for them, they're going to be able to do that here.
A look here at the scouting report. As there are the pitches and corresponding speeds we'll see him use this afternoon. DJ LeMahieu will get his first shot here. A couple of hits in four trips last night. First pitch on its way from Lee. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Going to be extra bases. He'll take the turn and head for second. And he'll pull in there with a double to start out the ball game.
Well, this guy's been in desperate need of anything, something. Give him something positive. So this is just what the doctor ordered. It's a mistaken location, no doubt about that. When a guy's scuffling, this is like a gift from heaven as he jumps all over it and drives it for two bases.
Now here's the first pitch. And a ball, 1-0. Here's Lee now on 1-0. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball, 1-1. The 1-1 from Lee. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
There's not a whole lot of conviction in that swing. It was almost like an afterthought, like an emergency hack.
Here comes the 1-2. Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Just amazing what this guy's done with the bat this year. I mean, even when he's in a two-strike hole, he still finds a way to come through.
Corey Dickerson will stand in here with a chance to pad his RBI total. And as you can see, he currently sits third in the National League in that category. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. And speaking of the NL RBI leaders, there they are on your screen. The 1-0 pitch. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So a three-run blast to deep center here. Seven home runs for him on the year now. And the Rockies have now taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, he worked himself into trouble out there right off the bat. He had to go through the heart of the order with guys on base. And now the next thing you know, he's already down 3-0 before he gets out of the first.
Here's Nolan Arenado. He'll take a look at a pitch too low. It's ball one. Would you say he's not really finishing his pitches at this point?
That's a good way to put it. It looks like he's aiming a little too much, and that's not working for him.
Three runs already home here. The next pitch. And here's a fastball in for strike one. 91 miles an hour that time. David Buchanan will be summoned now to take over following the injury. Ready now on 1-1. This is lined into left field, a base hit.
Well, he's already served up a three-run homer. Now, they're starting another rally right away. This hasn't been a very good first inning for him by any stretch, so he's going to need to put an end to this thing quick, or he's not going to be in the game much longer.
The catcher, Willene Rosario, now goes the other way and sends it deep down the right field line. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone, a home run. A two-run home run for Willene Rosario. And the Rockies are opening things up now. It's a 5-0 ball game.
Well, this is a fastball on the outside third of the plate. Look at him just reach those arms out and really drive this thing the other way. It didn't stay fair by much, but if you can steer him near the poles, you don't have to hit him 400 feet.
Boy, and a sign that things are not going smoothly. There's action in the bullpen here in the very first inning. Drew Stubbs comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. I think that man right there is reaching the end of his wits.
Oh, his team is absolutely imploding right now, and it basically came out of nowhere.
Swing and an easy one for the first baseman. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here.
And that's a pretty good job of staying with the ball, because he doesn't really panic after he planked it. And then he just regathers himself and fires a strike to first to get the out.
In now, Michael McHenry, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 287 the average coming in. One home run and 14 driven in. Here it comes. Yeehaw. Sticks with the fastball here as he forges ahead 0-2.
And I know it's your first at-bat of the ballgame and you want to work the count a little, but
those were two pretty good pitches to have a rip at.
And now a pitch on the way. And a swing and a miss is all he could do was reach out in vain for that one, and the side is retired. So give him five runs in the inning, with the big blows being the two home runs. On now to the bottom of inning number one. It's the Rockies 5 and the Phillies coming up. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Starting lineup for the Phillies is there on your screen. They'll go to work against a tough assignment indeed, the hard-throwing right-hander Jordan Lyles. Now a quick look at the defensive alignment for the Rockies. Ben Revere will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Eric, you take a look at these guys as they take the field for the bottom of the first here this afternoon. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
And they've split the first four games on this road trip, so lately they're in a bit of a holding pattern, but it could be ready to break out right here.
Now it's 2-0. On the way. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Not the start he was looking for here in the home first.
Yeah, and he even had himself a lead before he even threw a pitch out there. You think that alone would make you a little more relaxed and comfortable, but he looks a little tight to me.
3-0 is on the way. And that misses ball four, so that's just what you hope for here in the first. Base runners as you try to claw back into this one.
Yeah, not what you want to do here in this hostile ballpark. Walk the leadoff guy who just happens to be a threat to go every time he's on first. Tough way to start things out.
Salvador Perez will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. First pitch coming. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. He seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
Ball swung on and lifted in the air with some carry out towards left center. Therefore, it is Blackman, and he's got it for the first out.
Whoa, and as a pitcher, you hold your breath anytime a ball's hit in the air at this place, but luckily he got under this ball a little bit too much, and that runner has to retreat back to first base.
Adrian Beltre will get his first opportunity now. Runner still at first with one away. Now here's the first pitch. Revere rides off for second, and it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
There's some managers out there who'd say, we're already down a few runs here early. Let's not take too many chances on the base pass, but not this guy. He's not afraid to give his guys free rein out there, and this time it works out for him.
One out and a runner on second base. He's set. Now the pitch. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but he'll barely have to move out there and right as he hauls this one in for the second out.
And that's actually a lot tougher play than it looks out there in right field. You know, sometimes off of a right-hander's bat, that ball can kind of curl away from you, but he stays right with it to put it away.
Brandon Jordan will get his first opportunity here with the leadoff man still at second, but with two gone now. Here's the first offering. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. He waits. Now the pitch. And he goes the other way, but he got a lot of it deep down the line. But that'll be off the right field wall. And that'll put him on the board as it's now a 5-1 ball game. And he will pull into second with an RBI double.
Well, I got to tell you, I love the way this guy just lets it rip. Ahead in the count, behind in the count. It really doesn't matter to this guy. He's just going to go up hacking. And he drives in a run right here as he just drills this one for two bases.
Here's the left-handed hitting Dominic Brown. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He'll check in with an average still south of 230. 8 home runs and 14 driven in. Here comes the 1-0. Now a ball hit down the line in the air. This has a chance, and oh, it's high off the foul pole for a home run. Down the line in right field, home run number 9 on the year, and it's a 5-3 game now.
Well, you've got to imagine that out there on the mound. Once this ball leaves the bat, he's going to be thinking, all right, I'm out of the inning. But then this thing had a lot of carry to it. Nice backspin. And then it just doinks off that foul pole for a two-out, two-run homer. Those are the ones that really hurt.
First pitch on the way. Now a ball lying towards center field. And this is down in front of Stubbs for a base hit.
And when you see a guy rip one like this, one pitch after the previous guy left the yard, you know you're dealing with a pitcher whose mind is elsewhere. That'll snap you back to reality, though, pretty quick.
In is the second baseman, Chase Utley. As he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. 276, the average coming in for him. 4 home runs and an even 20 RBIs. He's ready. Now the pitch. And that misses 1-1. Here's the 1-1. And this is fouled back and out of play. A runner on first with two away. Here comes a 1-2. Now here's a swing and a ground ball. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. But they strike for 3 in the inning, 2 on this 2-run home run. Second inning coming up. It's the Rockies 5 and the Phillies 3. Jerome Williams is going to come on now here in just the second inning, so he'll likely be asked to work a few innings here. Jordan Lyles will get his first opportunity now. Sure sign that trouble is afoot, as there is already some action in that bullpen now, and we're just in the second inning. And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one.
Yeah, a tough situation here. He has the long inning on the mound, and he's got to turn right around and lead off the next half inning.
Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
Now the pitch. Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach. Here comes another 0-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
We showed you his numbers a minute ago. It's still early in the season to be worrying too much, but definitely off to a slow start. So he's going to need to string together a few good outings to lower that ERA a little bit.
Charlie Blackmon will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game. First offering on the way. Looked like he went around that time. They'll appeal down to third, and yes, sir, it's strike one. The pitch. Swing and a liner toward right center. Base hit. So it's a one-out single for him here in the second inning. Good time to check out the league leaders in hits. And as you see there, he finds himself in sixth place in the category in the National League. DJ LeMahieu will stand in. He doubled and later scored his first time. First pitch coming. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. The 1-0 home. And that's inside, looked like the slider, and it's 2-0.
Well, two very good takes here. You can see they're trying to get him to hit something on the ground, but he's going to make them bring something up.
The 2-0 on the way. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. Ready with the 2-1. And there he goes towards second. Now a swing and a ground ball. He's running again. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Now another 2-2. And this will be fouled away. Ready with another 2-2. On the ground down the first base line. One there. On to first, not in time, as the umpire was right there to make the call.
This is always a tough throw here for a first baseman coming off the bag. You got to make sure that you don't just throw the ball right into the runner's back heading down to second base. Here he takes just a little extra time to make sure that he makes a good throw. And they're going to settle for just one at second.
Genmar Gomez is going to come on now here in just the second inning, so he'll likely be asked to work a few innings here. Troy Tulowitzki will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. And here's the first pitch. Ball one.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
1-0 on the way. And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. One on the way. And a drive out to deep right center field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. One left for Colorado, and it remains 5-3. Michael Franco will take his first cuts of the ball game here.
The shortstop, Michael Franco.
First pitch coming. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. That misses, 2-0.
He's showing pretty good patience here for a rookie. Those were two tough takes, but he's got it to 2-0.
Now the 2-0 home. Oh, this is hit hard towards second. Oh, this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first down.
Oh, you can feel for him, too, because you know exactly what's going through his mind right there. He can't believe it. You know when you're going good at the plate, all the little flares and bleeders, they all start going your way and they fall in. But when you're scuffling like he has, even the Rockets find a glove.
Stepping in now, Genmar Gomez. As he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. The 1-0. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. The 1-1. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. The right-hander deals on 1-2. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
Well, these are just extra pitches adding to your pitch count. I don't see why you wouldn't just go right after him.
2-2 pitch on the way. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
3-2, here it is. Roasted into left field. That's a base hit.
Boy, how about that at-bat from your pitcher? You started thinking, this is already a really good at-bat because he's seen so many pitches, but then he caps it off by finishing it with a base hit.
Ben Revere will stand in for a second time. He drew a base on balls to lead off the home first. First pitch to him. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Runner at first here, one man out. He's ready now, the pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. Pause, now the pitch. And a pitch takes off inside and it gets away. And he'll make it in easily at second, as I'd imagine that'll be scored a passed ball.
With the passed ball there, that'll take away the possibility of getting a double play to end the inning. So that could come back to bite him.
The 1-2 with one away. To two balls and two strikes now.
Well, I'd be surprised if they go back to the curve again on 2-2. He's had a couple of pretty good looks at it at the plate.
Runner at second here with one man out. From the stretch. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. Here he comes on 2-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Due up next is Salvador Perez. Full count pitch on its way. Now he turns on a fastball and sends it deep down the right field line. Out of here! It was a wall scraper, but it counts just the same. A home run.
Just willing this thing fair, and sure enough, bonk, right off the foul pole, and he'll take it. That's number one of the year.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. You know, you start to worry that maybe this already has the makings of a short outing.
And that's not what that man right there wants to hear. He'd hate to have to make a change this early, but he might have to.
The 1-0. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two. Here comes the 2-0. Grounded fouled off to the right side. One out, nobody on. Now here it comes. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. Well into the outfield turf as he makes the stop. Flip from short right gets him, and there are two away. Adrian Beltre will stand in. A lineout victim his first time. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
Pitch on the way. And a fastball there is inside as that one backed him up a bit.
And we're going to see a lot more of this because this is a guy who's let it be known that he will work inside. He'll even back you off the plate if he has to.
And a fastball runs in a bit too close for comfort that time.
Yeah, I don't think this is a guy you want to mess with here. He can hurt you in more ways than one.
2-1. Grounded foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Here's the full count offering. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Now there are two ways you can go here as a pitching coach. So he's got to make a judgment call out there. He knows what buttons to press with each of his pitchers. Some guys you've got to reassure and be very positive with. You know, other guys, they respond better when you go out and challenge them. You really got to read them the riot act.
Brandon Jordan will stand in. An RBI double to his credit the first time around. Here's the first offering. Up and in for ball one. Do that. 1-0 pitch now.
Here we go.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Another 2-0 count here to begin an at-bat.
Once or twice is a pattern. More than that is a trend. And he's just not going to have much success if he keeps falling behind every hitter.
Here we go, Brandon. Come on.
Maybe trouble now. Here's the 2-0. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. And that's through for a base hit.
Boy, the hits just keep on coming here. You see the highlighted column right there. That's six against him already, and we're just in the second inning.
Dominic Brown. See what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home here in the inning so far. Beltre off second. Here's the pitch. Here's a swing by Brown as he sends a ground ball out to second base. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. But the fight and strike for a pair, both coming on this two-run home run. We've played two, all even at five apiece. Corey Dickerson, ready to go here as we begin the third.
Corey Dickerson.
Now the first pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Now the 1-0. And he misses again, 2-0. And this is something we've seen a lot from him recently. He's worked his way into another good hitter's count.
Yeah, it's not unrelated either. When you're going good at the plate, usually means you're being selective and you're not getting yourself out. And when that happens, you'll find yourself in these kind of counts.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
That one's in there, 3-1.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while, and when he does, you can forget it.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And after your guys just gave you two runs the last half inning, you don't want to start giving them right back. A leadoff walk? I mean, no way. You can't do that right there.
Nolan Arenado will get his first shot here with the runner on following the leadoff walk. Comes set. Now the pitch. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. Tag applied by Utley, and he is out at second base.
Well, showed a lot of patience to work out the walk, but then he got a little impatient trying to steal second base. They throw him out pretty easily there on the first pitch.
Here's the pitch. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. One pitch on the way. Fouled straight back. Here's the 1-2. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
Well, let's take a look at the sequence here on Showtrack. The first three pitches, they're all going to be down in the zone. So now you've got the guy thinking he's going to see something else around the knees. Boom. That's when they change the sight level and get that last pitch by him at the letters.
The catcher, Willene Rosario, now. As he'll take a look at ball one.
1-0.
Both teams with six hits so far. And the pitch. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. The 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. A 2-1 offering. Swung on and hit in the air out toward left. Brown is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three, and we are all tied 5-5. Darren Ruff will lead it off here for Philadelphia to be followed on deck by Chase Utley. Now here's the first pitch. And here's one that misses to the leadoff man in the inning. The number six hitter in the lineup, it's ball one.
Now after a rough couple of innings, you'd like to give your guy a chance to straighten himself out here, but I also think you got to keep your options open in case he just doesn't have it.
And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground, but foul. Here's the 1-1. This one's in there. Maybe should have been strike three, but instead it's 1-2 now. Now the 1-2. And that's off his leg on the mound. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it, it looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. So one gone here in the Philadelphia third, and making his way in is the second baseman, Chase Utley. First pitch coming. Swing and a liner, but this is going to get foul. Here it comes. Now a swing by Utley as he launches this one out to deep right field. And that one is out of here. Planted into the right field bleacher. Solo shot that time from Chase Utley. Home run number 5 on the year. And this one gives him the lead at 6-5.
That's 3 home runs he's allowed in the first 3 innings of work, and I gotta think that they've seen enough, haven't they? I just can't see him turning things around the way he's been getting lit up so far.
Into the box now, Michael Franco. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one.
Feels like he's kind of relied a little too much on that fastball.
And it's gotten him into trouble. I think guys have just gone up there looking for it, and usually they wind up getting it.
Here's a 1-0. Fouled toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. Now the 1-1. And he swings and pops it foul behind the plate. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Xavier Paul will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Xavier Paul.
And this could wind up being a bullpen kind of game as we've got action down there right now when we're only in the third inning. Now a swing and a fly ball. And that will end up a foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Now the pitch. And he drops that one in for strike two.
Now 0-2 here. This is where you need to expand the zone. If it's close, you got to let it fly.
The pitch. Here's a swing, and oh, man! way out of here. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Home run number 5 on the year, and they take a 7-5 lead.
Hitter down in the count like that, you gotta bury him or at least get him to chase something out of the zone. That pitch is way too hittable and he pays for it. Just an enormous mistake, and now he's so upset with himself.
Here's Ben Revere. He'll go after the first pitch and send a ground ball down to third. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So they get a couple of runs on 2 hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. 3 innings complete. Phillies on top, 7-5. Justin DeFreitas is going to come on and make an appearance here, though I suspect even he couldn't have predicted he'd be taking over in just the 4th inning. Drew Stubbs will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
Center fielder number 13, Drew Stubbs.
And here's a fastball called for strike 1. Now the pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And a slider misses here. 2 balls and a strike.
He showed him that slider running away 2 times in a row. Now might be a good time to call on that two-seamer running in.
Here it comes, 2-1. To 2-2 now. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
Here comes a 2-2. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch. A ball hit hard to the left side. But Beltre is able to get his glove up and spear this one out of midair for the first out.
And that's one of those plays where you might need to reinforce the laces on your glove after this inning ends. This is a fastball, and it is hammered. I mean, hammered out there. But he's going to wind up with nothing to show for it.
Now a left-hander up and throwing in that Philly bullpen. Standing in now, Michael McHenry, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball 1.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a 2-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
5 runs, 6 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. 1-0 on the way. And this is going to be a foul ball. The 1-1 home. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Well, nothing fancy. 3 fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
Bases are empty, 1 man out. 1-2. In the air to right center. Revere will range to his left and put it away. 2 down.
How about it? The pitcher, Jordan Lyon.
Justin Morneau. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 33, Justin Morneau.
In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. Here's the 1-0. In tight again, and it's to 2-0 now.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
2-0 count, the pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. There to get it is Upley. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. They're down 2-7-5. Christian Friedrich is going to come on and make an appearance here, though I suspect even he couldn't have predicted he'd be taking over in just the fourth inning. Salvador Perez will try it again, 0-for-2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. And now a pitch on the way. This is hit sharply to the left side. Oh, and it eats him up a bit.
It's been a game of offense so far, so no surprise the leadoff man's on base again. So let's see what we've got in store for us this time around.
Adrian Beltre will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Now the first pitch. He's running towards second. Swing and he pops him up. Behind the bag at second. And Tulowitzki takes this one for the first out.
Popping it up is bad enough, but doing it on the first pitch, you know, and out of the zone to boot. I mean, this just is not a good AB. I can tell you that.
Brandon Jordan will dig in. He singled his last time around. Here's the first offering. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Here's the 1-0. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. And they'll get the fielder's choice play at second, but that's all.
Well, you could have put the first base bag out in the outfield grass on this play. You're not going to double this guy up. He's too fast. Still, a pretty good job of at least getting that lead runner at second base.
Dominic Brown will step in. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. First pitch on the way. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. And you figure now this would be a spot where that man might try to take second base.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to hold the ball a little longer out there on the mound. Really bury your times to the plate. You can't be predictable out there or he'll take advantage.
The 1-0 pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. Here comes the 1-1. Up high. 2-1 now. Here's the 2-1 pitch. At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. 1-2 offering. Runner goes for second, and he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. One left for Philadelphia. They're still up 7-5. Charlie Blackmon will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. First offering on the way. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one. This man out for his second inning of work. Did a nice job getting them 1-2-3 last time around.
Yeah, but that was against the 7-8-9 guys. Things may be a little more difficult here now that he has to face the top three in the lineup.
Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Now the 1-1 pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. Swung on and hit in the air down the left field line. And a diving try in left, but he can't come up with it. He's around second now, and they still haven't gotten to this thing. Oh, and he ignores the third base coach and heads for home. A tag from Perez. He's out at the plate.
Well, you know, sometimes after you've run that far, you just figure, what the heck, I'm going to go for it. But I think he blew a gasket there about halfway down the third baseline, and they wind up tagging him out, trying for that inside the Parker. You know, my motto is, run till they tag you.
Here's the second baseman, D.J. LeMahieu. Yeah. He'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him because that thing was right down Broadway.
Pitch on the way. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
Ready now on 1-1. Fastball called strike. 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. 5 runs, 7 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. The 2-2. Swing, hard hit ball to second, and it comes up on Utley. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. It's fair to say that early on, at least, the runs have come in bunches here this afternoon. A high-scoring affair thus far, and we're only in the fifth inning. Jake Diekman is going to take over here in inning number 5, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. So two are gone in the Rockies' half of the fifth. And danger now is standing in as the fine shortstop, Troy Tulowitzki. Now here's the pitch. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now the 1-0 pitch. This ball will be chopped foul. Here's the 1-1. A ball and two strikes the count now with the bases empty and two away. There's the lefty's offering on 1-2. Oh, don't know how you lay off that one, but he did, and it's 2-2.
And that's the right spot for that slider. Really try hard to tie him up inside, and that's a good job to lay off, too.
The 2-2 coming. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. Here now the 2-2. Now a ball hit hard towards center. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out.
Well, here we are. It's the second month of the season, and this guy is showing no signs of slowing down. Got himself another multi-hit ball game here.
Corey Dickerson will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. First pitch coming. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. The next pitch. That's wide, 2-0.
2-0.
Here comes the 2-0. 3-0 now.
And he's got to be up there thinking, come on already. Give me something to hit.
Two out with the man at first. Now the 3-0 offering. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
Not turned loose there. I thought that he might be swinging with two away, but apparently not.
Here he comes, 3-1. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Oh, and you know he wanted that one. Now the inning will continue, and a guy moves up into scoring position here.
Nolan Arenado. We'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in inning number five. Now here's the first pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Here comes the 1-0. 2-0 now.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in a strike zone.
Now the 2-0. Swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Now the 2-1 pitch. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Now the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a shot toward right center. And he will run this one down as he pulls it in around the letters, and the inning is over. Two left for Colorado. They're down 7-5. Darren Ruff will lead it off here for Philadelphia, to be followed on deck by Chase Utley. That Colorado bullpen comes to life now with a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
You don't want guys to get too comfortable up there, so that's a good idea to run something in tight.
1-0 on the way. Hammered the other way to deep right field. And say goodbye to that one. Into the seats and right for a home run. A solo home run off the bat of Darren Ruff. Home run number 5 on the year as they open up an 8-5 lead.
Guys are putting in their pregame meal, you can be darn sure they're getting the same setup tomorrow. That's 5 home runs as a team now. I mean, these guys are feeling it up there.
Chase Utley will stand in now following the home run, and you wonder if that losing streak is about to go by the wayside.
Well, they're not home yet, but certainly this has been a much better performance than we've seen out of them for a while now. So all signs seem to be pointing to a potential victory.
First pitch coming. And they start him with one high and away for ball one. Utley awaits the 1-0. Oh, and he drives one into deep right center. But that'll be off the wall in right center. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Well, you know he's got one home run already. And I think off the bat right there, he was pretty sure he got another one. But you can see this ball's going to wind up just a little bit short as it kicks off the wall. And he's going to have to settle for just a two-base hit this time.
Michael Franco will step forward now. Lined out and popped out in his previous two trips. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And here's the first pitch. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out toward right. Dickerson is there to put it away for out number one. Freddie Galvis will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here as he'll pinch hit now with one away. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Set now the pitch. Now a swing and a ball pulled down the line to third, but this will get foul for strike two. He's set now the pitch, and strike three called on the outside corner. He's earned the right to live out there with the fastballs as that's out number two.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Here's Ben Revere. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Tough spot here for a left-handed hitter facing a guy that's exceptionally tough on lefties.
Yeah, you generally get so many at-bats against right-handed pitching. Now you're in a good RBI spot.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. Throw from a knee is too late, and that will be an infield single.
Boy, what a great effort just to knock this one down before it gets into center field. But that was going to be asking a lot for him to get up and throw his man out. And as you can see there, that throw is well late.
Some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as this is popped foul behind the plate at strike one. Has a look, now the pitch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Here's the 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. here comes the 2-1. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. Well, as if things weren't bad enough, he's in danger now of loading the bases for that man.
Yeah, I don't think that's ever a sound strategy in anybody's book.
Now the 3-1 pitch. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
And now, 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Runners at the corners, two men out. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And that one's out of here. What another nickel in the merry-go-round. This one is getting ugly. So a three-run shot to left center. Home run number 5 on the year as it's now a 6-run ball game.
Talk about an offensive explosion. That's 6 home runs as a team so far. I mean, you might get that once a season. The whole lineup's been absolutely dialed in.
Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball 1.
Oh, man, if you're a pitching coach, you might want to update your resume after this performance. His guys have been brutal.
The 1-0 home. And a fastball runs a bit inside. He's down 2-0.
Normally that two-seamer has a lot more movement to it. Now it's been pretty straight for him in this one, and he's gotten into trouble because of it.
Here's the 2-0 pitch. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Here he comes on 2-1.
Ball 3, and they know full well the threat that this guy poses. So even down 3-1, I can't imagine he's going to get anything that he can drive right here.
The 3-1 is on the way. Fastball too low, and that's ball 4.
And that's not the first time he's had the bat taken out of his hands. You see right there, a lot of pitchers just said, hey, with an open base, forget about it. I'm going to let the next guy try to beat me.
And we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. In now, Brandon Jordan, as he swings and pops this one foul off to the right, out of play. He's set. Now the pitch. Chopped foul at the plate here, and it's 0-2. Four runs here in this half inning. From the belt, the pitch. Oh, he went for the knockout pitch that time, but a good eye, 1-2.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
Here comes a 1-2 to 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase, so... Now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Here's the 2-2 home. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that that runner gets a head start from first with 2 away.
The 3-2 pitch. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. Throw on to first will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. Another good inning here for the Phillies, and the brotherly love is in abundance now. More of the show, Saturday Baseball, after this. Ken Giles will get the call here as he'll start the 6th inning on the mound. Willene Rosario will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Here as this is yanked down the third baseline. This is foul for the first strike. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Here's the pitch. Down and away, ball one. The 1-1. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two. Now here's the pitch. Now a foul tip straight into the catcher's glove, and he's able to hang on to record the first out of the inning.
If you're not expecting this pitch, it's hard to really do much of anything with it. You can see this is a hard slider bearing down and in, and folks, that is nasty.
Here's Drew Stubbs now. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Boy, I don't know that I'd want to be facing this guy right now. He looks pretty fired up out there.
Yeah, he looks like he could run that fastball through a brick wall.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Now you've got a 6-run lead out there, and there's no reason not to come right at guys.
The 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
And from where I'm sitting, you know, this guy looks to be a guy that's starting to rush out there now. Might not be a bad idea for the catcher to try and slow him down a bit.
The 3-0. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
One on the way. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. That's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
Full count offering on its way. Now a half swing, but it's strike three anyway, says the home plate umpire. And that's out number two.
And here this is one more time on show track. You can see check his swing there, and I think he did so in time, but you can clearly see that that pitch is in the strike zone, and I think ultimately that was a called third strike.
Stepping in now, Michael McHenry, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Two out, nobody on. The 1-0. Now a check swing, but he makes contact and hits it out in front of the plate. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Colorado. They'll need better than that, down 11-5. Boone Logan will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Now a right-hander has started to get loose in the Colorado bullpen. Dominic Brown is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Now here it comes. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Some would say he's showing good patience here, waiting for his pitch. But as a number five hitter, I think you need to make something happen.
The pitch. And, oh, he got the glove up in time as this ball grills him. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. Darren Ruff. We'll stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. First pitch to him. First pitch fastball, swung on and missed 0-1.
Yeah, and that's the swing of a guy hoping for a first-pitch curveball right there. If he gets it, he hammers it. If not, he's about 3 feet too late.
Come on, Philly.
Now the pitch. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Yeah, this pitch is just nowhere near the target. You see it run in and catch it right about thigh high.
I have a feeling the bruise will be worse than the pain. That'll leave a nice rainbow for a good couple of weeks.
Chase Utley will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Here's the first pitch to him. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
That's what you need to do after a hit by pitch. Get right back on that horse and fire a fastball in there.
He waits. Now the pitch. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike. One pitch on the way. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Runners on first with one down. The 1-2 with one away. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. And over the scoreboard, home run. A Utley, his second of the game.
Everybody in this lineup's gonna have a home run before this one's done. That's seven home runs as a team.
The batter number seven, shortstop.
Into the box, Michael Franco. And he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's gonna be sleeping well tonight, is it?
One out, nobody on. The 1-0. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
I think he's letting this situation get the better of him out there. But you have to have a short memory if you're a relief pitcher. You can't dwell on what just happened.
The 2-0. And this one's over at the knees, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Taken the other way, but this should be routine out there in right field. Dickerson is in his tracks now, and he's got it for out number two.
The pitcher, number 53,
Ken Giles will stand in now, and given the big cushion he has to work with on the other side of the scorecard, he'll go ahead and hit for himself here in inning number six. Now the first pitch. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here it comes. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
He's just working east and west here. He'll be fine if he just stays out of the middle.
Pitch on the way. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. They'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Here's the 1-2. Slice down the line at first, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Here's another 1-2. Lays off, 2-2 now.
Boy, that's pretty good patience out there out of a pitcher who's acting like a hitter, especially with two outs.
Two-two pitch on the way. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. So two runs on one hit, and the one hit was a big one, the home run. Seventh inning coming up. Philadelphia's on top, 13-5. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. This one pretty much all over, but the shouting as we check our game summary to see how we've gotten to where we are. Nick Hundley is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number seven.
Nick Hundley.
Fastball by him here, 0-1. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
Now the pitch. Fastball that time is nowhere close, and it's even at 1-1. And that misses, 2-1.
This is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. And that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
Now the 2-1. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Now the 3-1. Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2.
Yeah, that finds a zone, but some of these pitches are getting a little too much elevation. That could come back to bite him.
Easy,
Now the 3-2 pitch. Swinging a ball hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out.
Boy, just so late on that fastball, and you're not too surprised about that when you're facing a reliever that throws as hard as this guy does. And it's an easy play at first to take it himself for the out.
Here's Charlie Blackmon now, and he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate here as that misses.
I don't think there's any intent with that. That might be just to let him know that he's out there.
One oh pitch now. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's the 1-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Since coming in the sixth, I mean, he's knocked down five in a row. It's giving him a real lift out there.
DJ LeMahieu.
DJ LeMahieu will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Now here's the first pitch. And he popped him up. Back into foul territory behind first. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Here's the pitch. Really dotting the corners here with the fastball. 0-2. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
Now here's the pitch. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2.
1-2 is the count.
Right-hander deals on 1-2. Now a ball lined to the right side, and that'll get down for a two-out single.
I tell you, he has not looked like a 220 hitter to me. This is his second hit of the ball game, and he smoked this one pretty good.
Troy Tulowitzki will get another shot now, 2-for-3 in the game. Here's the first offering. Now a fastball. Look out as he has to duck out of harm's way there. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Here's the 1-0 offering now to Tulowitzki. And here's a fastball inside as the count moves to 2-0 now.
Now on 2-0. Got a fastball count, and we've got a good fastball hitter. That might spell some trouble if he indeed gets one out over the plate.
Here's the 2-0. 3-0 now.
Yeah, it looked like he was well on his way to a quick inning, but now a hit and a 3-0 count have turned the tables on that idea.
Here it is, the 3-0. That one's in there, 3-1.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer it that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
The 3-1 coming. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
And it looked like he was on his way to breezing through this half inning. But then a base base hit, now a walk here with two away, and that's opened the door for these guys to maybe do some damage after all.
Corey Dickerson will get his shot now with two on and two out here in inning number seven. First pitch coming. Oh, tried to hold back as this is hit back toward the mound. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Well, nothing going right on the mound for him right now. This is going to be scored an infield single. And that's just going to make matters worse out there as that loads the bases.
Jonathan Papelbon will come on much too early here if you ask me. It's just the seventh inning. Here's Nolan Arenado as he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1.
Yeah, definitely take it all the way. Not a bad idea with the bases loaded.
Two out, bases loaded. He's ready now. The pitch outside for a ball, 1-1.
Let's get out of this inning.
Here's Papelbon's 1-1. And this pitch is hit rather sharply toward the third base coaching box. It's a foul ball. Pitch here, 1-2. And tough fastball to lay off on 1-2, but he did, and it's 2-2 now.
Oh, that's a tough take, but a good one. The pressure's still squarely on the pitcher out there. He's still got to come in.
A deep breath, now the 2-2. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here's another 2-2. Swing and a liner towards second. That's in there. Base hit. One run is scored. And the second run will score as well.
Now batting, the first baseman,
Willene Rosario, will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. Right-hander starts to loosen out from the bullpen now. Now the first pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Bottom of the seventh now. Get up and stretch here in Philly. The Phillies lead it 13-7. Adam Ottavino will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Ben Revere will dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. Too low, 1-0. Now the 1-0. Here's Tulowitzki at short. Throw in the dirt to first, and he can't come up with it cleanly.
Yeah, a good effort there at first. Here's the stretch on show motion. The throw to the right field side of the bag, and you see him swing that left leg all the way around and try and backhand this thing, and it winds up hopping right over the top of his glove.
Salvador Perez will dig in. Had a three-run homer his last time. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. First pitch on the way. And that misses ball one.
And you can see it. He's upset with himself out there at short. And he should be. He's a big leaguer. He'd like to get a ground ball here to get himself off the hook.
One-oh on the way. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. One-one on the way. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
When you start that pitch off the edge, most guys know well enough to lay off. You've got to start it on the edge if you want him to chase.
The 2-1. This is hit on the ground, but foul. Here he comes on 2-2. Swing and a foul tip, but that's held onto behind the plate. It's a strikeout for out number one.
Well, you never know. This might have been the lesser of two evils right here. If you take this pitch, you know it's strike three. If you swing, you might bounce into a double play ball. So the best he could have done was maybe fouled that thing off, but instead, he comes up empty.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre, as he will take a look at a fastball in there as that strike zone expands just a little. It's 0-1.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
From the belt, kicks and deals. One strike pitch is a fastball high, and that evens things at one. Runner at first here, one man out. Here's the 1-1 now to Beltre. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Kulawiczki for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. More from the show, Saturday Baseball, following this message and a word from our local station. Drew Stubbs will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Drew Stubbs.
First offering on the way. On to the eighth here as a slider is taken to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. Here's a 1-0. Ball two. Now the 2-0. In there, 2-1. The 2-1 home. Good fastball that time as he's pulled the count back to even now. It's 2-2.
Well, you can tell he's trying to work that pitch away, but he might have left that one a little more over the plate than he intended.
Two, two. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. 2-2. Here it comes. Swing and a line drive to left. He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first out.
Another look here. This ball's sinking fast, but he's on the full run, and he lays out to pull it in. That's well done there.
Standing in now, Michael McHenry. And he takes ball one.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. That's a strike in the rule book, but most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Here's the 1-0. That missed. Close. It's ball two.
And Papelbon gave a little extra look in there. Now, he thought it was a strike, too.
One out, nobody on. Hitters count 2-0. A ball hit hard to the left side. And, oh, he can't knock this one down as it zips right by him into left.
Yeah, a hot shot that time and a tough read down there at third base. He just couldn't get the leather on it.
Roger Bernardina will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Here's the 1-0. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
A couple of tight pitches here to start this at bat. You can't really say you're getting squeezed, but he's not really getting any help either.
Runners on first with one down. The 2-0 on the way. And this is a called strike at the letters. Looked like ball three, but make it 2-1 instead.
Whew, that's a gift.
Ready on 2-1. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. Look at the stop. What a flip for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Nothing doing for the Rockies. They trail in this wild affair. John Axford will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Brandon Jordan will try again. 2-for-4 in the ballgame.
Right fielder, Brandon Jordan.
First pitch of the inning misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Oh yeah. 2-0 on the way. In the dirt. It's 3-0 now. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
Here comes the 3-0. And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
And the pitch. And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eight.
And you'd like to say, good job there, good eye. But in reality, nobody's swinging at that pitch. It's not even close.
Dominic Brown will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Here's the first offering. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Comes set, now the pitch. Now a ball sprayed foul into the seats near third. From the stretch. And this is on the ground to first. Could be two. There's one. Throw on to first. Won't be in time, so they just get the one there.
You know, that's one of the toughest double plays to try and turn. They do get the lead runner at second base, but then that return throw to the pitcher covering at first never really had much of a chance.
In now, Darren Ruff, as he'll take a look at ball one.
One and up. Come on, get the runner to second.
The next pitch. Ball two now.
Two times here they've gone away. Both pretty easy takes. And as a hitter, now I'm thinking it might be time they try to bust something inside.
Runner at first here, one man out. Here comes the 2-0. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Ready with the 2-1. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. In danger now of a second walk out of the bullpen.
Not exactly providing relief. He's got to find it here somehow.
Runners on first with one down. Here he comes on 3-1. Now this ball's hit back up the middle, and he's got himself another base hit, his third of the afternoon.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see it get past second base where neither middle infielder can track it down. And it'll make its way into center field.
In is the second baseman, Chase Utley, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Here comes the 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. Just fire that thing in there.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. This is hit sharply to the left side. And that's in there, base hit. And they'll quickly get it in here to hold that runner at third base.
Now batting, the shortstop,
Mike Del Fronto will look to keep pouring it on as he stands in with the bases loaded. Now the pitch lays off 1-0. Bad time for the strike zone to go MIA.
Yeah, and he could have used that one, no doubt about it.
Now the 1-0 pitch lays off again, and it's 2-0.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
Bases are loaded with only one out. Two-oh count, the pitch. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. Brown scores. And the second run will score as well.
And the beat goes on. Another great at-bat, and what else is new? They've now thrown 15 runs up on the scoreboard. Now that is a good day's work.
Rex Brothers will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Jonathan Papelbon comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Runners are at first and third, one away. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
You can bet he's going to keep right on watching until he gets a strike.
Here comes the 2-0. Down low, and the clock thickens here, 3-0.
Boy, this is just getting worse and worse for him. You certainly don't want to walk the bases loaded.
Here he comes on 3-0. A strike, and it's 3-1.
Don't be surprised if he still doesn't have the green light on 3-1.
The 3-1. That's hard hit back up the middle. Ah, flip of his glove for one. On to first, and talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Charlie Blackmon will stand in now to begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yep, this is mop-up time out there right now, but hey, these at-bats still count.
Sorry, but that ball's well hit into the gap in left center field, and this looks to be good for extra bases. And he is in to second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
That's a great swing there. Leading off an inning, it's a fastball, but he just goes right with it and drives it the other way toward the gap. He's going to wind up on second here with a leadoff double.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. He's set. Now the pitch. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
Yeah, not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
The 1-1 home. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Now the 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2. On deck, there you see Troy Tulowitzki. Now the payoff pitch home. Now a swing as he hits this one into the air. Well, this will be foul off to the right, out of play. Once again, a 3-2. Has to fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. Now the 3-2 pitch. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Revere comes on now and he has it, one down. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
The shortstop, number
Troy Tulowitzki, will get another shot now. 2-for-3 in the game. First pitch coming. And he didn't miss that by much. It's popped way up on the infield, and I mean way up there. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Corey Dickerson will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. Now here's the first pitch. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. The 1-0 home. That's inside. 2-0. Looks like he's not going to see anything here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. They gave him two shots to see if he'd go out of the zone to try to chase. And after that, I'm thinking they should just put him on.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Yeah, he got his 2-0 fastball, but it wasn't in that one place, one spot that we always talk about. So that was a good idea to let that one go and wait for something else.
A 2-1 offering. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Yeah, and you know what? You've got a better matchup on deck here with two outs. So on 3-1 now, they may not take any chances with this guy.
Here comes the 3-1. And he takes ball four again. And clearly, guys, they just don't want any part of him in this one.
Hey, that's a great job to work out the walk there. If that's one thing managers like to see. You got to die hard at the plate, even down to your final out. You never know in this game.
Nolan Arenado will be the batter. He singled home a couple in his last at-bat. He's set. Now the pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Lays off the fastball away, and it's 2-0. Eric, what are you looking for here?
It's a fastball count, but he doesn't always play by the rules out there, so this could very well be a slider or something away. So, in other words, I have no idea.
Now the 2-0. And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. But he will make the catch on the hard hit ball out there, and that will conclude matters here as this ball game is over.
Boy, I tell you, the way these guys fought back in this one was really something to watch. They were down 5 runs at one point this game, but they rallied all the way back, and now they come away with the victory.
Well, this one pretty much over before it started as we give you a final look at the line score here in what turned out to be a blowout victory. And the big bat for the Phillies this afternoon belonged to this fella, Chase Utley. Take a snapshot of that. He's our top player.